to get her to hospital. Help my wife, please. She's pregnant.
Come on. My stomach. It hurts. What's wrong?
Her name's Yaz Cunningham. She suddenly collapsed. She was sick on the way here.
OK, Yaz, we're going to get you a scan and we're going to find out exactly what's going on.
She's partially deaf.
Oh. OK. There we go. We're going to get you a scan, OK?
Will the baby be OK?
We need to get her upstairs right now.
Hey, Donna, wait.
Listen, I am so, so sorry, but I swear I didn't mean to hurt you.
No, I'm sorry. This world at the moment. Some of us are still grieving.
I know. We all are. Look, just because...
What, you kissed Joel? You're going to tell me now the man of God was offering you comfort?
I'm sorry you saw that. No, it meant nothing. And it won't happen again. It was just a brief moment where I forgot everything that was going on.
Oh, look at you.
Donna Marie, I know you feel like you're alone. But you're not. I am here. Like it or not, for as long as you need me.
What if you get a better offer?
What's a better offer than being your bestie? Yeah.
How's Perry doing?
Not great. She's crying herself to sleep, thinking we can't hear her. She's gonna go and stay with Acid for a bit, so I'm gonna go and help her pack.
Yeah, you do that. Spend time with her. Take every chance you can get.
Listen, I am going to hang around you like the smell of dry shampoo, okay? And I'm not going to let Joel or anyone else get in the way, okay?
Yeah.
Hi!
Tom! Just spoke to Miss Beth. She says to call when you get any news.
All I know is that she went straight from the scan into surgery. I'm waiting to hear.
Surgery? Well, at least we know she's in safe hands now, inshallah. Is Yaz okay? Can you tell me anything?
Just that she's in recovery, which means she's out of surgery. That's a good thing.
Okay, but what about the baby?
I really can't tell you anything more. I didn't operate on your wife. It was actually Mr. Sony. Mr. Sony, this is Mrs. Cunningham's husband, Tom.
They're taking your wife back down to her room, if you'd like to come with me.
Is everything all right?
I really do think it's best that I speak to you both together. Shall we?
Yaz.
Tom.
So, how are you feeling?
Awful. I'm not in agony, so...
Good. As you know, the scan revealed an ectopic pregnancy. That's when an embryo develops in a fallopian tube. You were yet to have your first ultrasound, is that correct?
Yeah, it's set for next week.
Had it been spotted earlier, it could have been treated with drugs or monitored. But the tube had ruptured, so I performed a laparotomy to stop the bleeding.
So does that mean...
But the sad fact is that ectopic pregnancies are simply unable to survive. There was no chance the fetus would grow to term. Therefore, we had to operate to ensure the risk to Yasmin was taken away. This means that, unfortunately, we had to end the pregnancy. I'll let you process your loss and pop back after I've had a chance to further assess the ultrasound with my team. Until then, maybe try and get some rest.
Tom.
No, I'm sorry. I think I just need a minute.
Tom? Are you okay? What's wrong?
It's gone.
hadn't really told anyone.
What? Who has gone? Yaz? I mean, is she okay?
She's fine. She never even...
Oh, Tom, come here, it's okay.
No, it's not. Our baby's gone.
Oh, yeah. I think we need to talk, don't we?
Why?
Well, I mean, I heard you talking to Donna Marie and... Well, I heard you saying, obviously, it meant nothing and...
Right, about that.
You were right. Okay, I caught you at a moment of weakness and I'm sorry.
No, you have got nothing to apologise for.
You're in pain, you're grieving and, No, I chose the wrong way to try and take that away.
What I said to Donna Marie was that I wish she hadn't had to see us.
Oh.
No, it's not right throwing it in her face right now.
All right, no. You're right. She just, stay friends.
Exactly. Friends. We can't let this get in the way.
No, you're right. Well, I think that's the right call.
Friends.
Definitely.
You're looking better than before.
Yeah, but I don't feel it. The baby's gone. Tom's not handling it well.
These things take time.
Sorry, can you say that again? I can't hear anything more than a meter away. But I can lip read pretty well.
You did tell me, and I do apologise. I was just saying that these things take time. Can I ask, have you always been partially deaf?
No. It was an explosion. An attack a few years ago in our back garden. The way I look at it is it could have been a lot worse. Oh.
Sorry, shall I come back?
No. Sit down.
I'll be here if you need me.
Thank you.
I've just seen Tom outside. I'm so sorry. You know, when you first find out, your entire life changes, and then when it doesn't happen...
Have you... too?
A long time ago. A miscarriage. Oh, I'm sorry, Yaz. Are you even okay to talk about this?
What is there to talk about? The baby's gone.
And Tom really wanted it.
He was made up. Basically the best thing that could have ever happened to him. And then I had to open my big gob and...
And say what?
That I didn't want it. Then I doubled over in pain, like I brought it on myself.
Yes, don't be daft. It don't work like that.
I know that. It's just... I just feel like me and Tom just want different things.
Okay, so... This is just the hormones talking. It's still really raw.
But our family is everything that Tom's ever wanted. What if I've taken that away from him? Oh, Tom. But I said earlier, I know how much you wanted this baby, and I'm so sorry.
This is not your fault. It's just one of those things. We can't let it beat us.
I don't want to lose you.
You're not gonna lose me. I love you, Yaz.
I love you too. So much.
Do you need more time alone, or is now good to continue our discussion? As I said, I wanted to speak to other members of my team after checking the ultrasound. I've done that. So, during surgery, I attempted to repair the damaged fallopian tube. It wasn't possible, so the tube was removed.
Okay.
As I'm afraid was the adjacent ovary, which was also badly damaged. I did notice an abnormality in the other ovary, so another ultrasound was performed.
It showed what?
I appreciate this won't be easy to hear, and I'd suggest getting a second opinion or getting further investigation. But as your remaining ovary is abnormally smaller than usual, added to blockages in your fallopian tube, in my opinion, you'll be unable to conceive naturally again.